Frank Mihalic here. I'd like to talk for a couple minutes to try to help you out with your black fishing game. There's a whole different thing between being a black fisherman and being a big blackfish guy. It's kind of a whole different mindset. And one of the first things, one of the most important skills you need to learn is how to get fish to bite. Not the big fish, but how to get any blackfish to bite, because there's notorious times during the day where they're just going to shut down and you're not going to be able to get a bite to save your life. And one of the main things you need to be able to do is fish a slack line. There's a lot of equipment tricks that are going to help you with this. And there's also just a lot of talent and skill that you're just going to have to develop. And you also need to know what fishing a slack line is. Fishing a slack line means keeping the line taut, but not tight enough to lift the sinker. So if you could see, this rod balance is just perfect in my hand. So if the boat's rocking and I'm going up and down, my rod's going to do this, and I'm going to sit here and roll a little bit on the balls of my feet. My rod's going to go up and down, but that line is just going to stay taut. When I feel a blackfish take the bait, it's immediately going to change. I'm going to go into a strike position like this. I might start off with a little scratch, and maybe that little scratch stops. Reel in, and I'm going to put some new bait on my hook, nice fresh bait, because every time you throw your bait down there, the burgalls and the blackfish eat the guts out of the crab. Some days those blackfish are going to eat a knuckle. They're going to eat anything that's down there. They're going to crush it. And there's other days where those blackfish, they won't eat that crab if the guts are sucked out of it. I don't know why, but they get really picky, and sometimes that's what it takes. So you pull up and you rebait. You get that little scratch. And once again, it stops. They're a little picky this day. So I'm going to rebait my hook for the second time, cast it out. Maybe this is the third time I'm rebaiting. Maybe it's the fourth time and the fish are still just pecking. When I do feel this fish give me the committal tug, I'm gonna make sure I swing for the fences. Now I just turned his head and I have him out of the structure. I wanna move my rod butt immediately in front of my gut. My hand is on my foregrip and I'm cranking for all I'm worth. This first 10 seconds of this battle, if you can turn this fish's head and get him lifted off the bottom, just enough. The rest of the battle is a whole different thing and you can adapt during it. But if you don't turn his head and get him off the structure and use the proper gear to make that happen, none of these other things matter. This is where black fishermen adapt and learn to catch bigger blackfish. It's in this whole few seconds of the fight. As soon as I get that rod tip up, I'm immediately cranking this thing as fast as I can until the fish stops me. I'm doing the best I can to hang on. Notice the rod is still in my gut. My hand's still on the foregrip. I'm using the fulcrum. I'm using the tool as it's meant to be. If you're a black fisherman and you're holding your rod with one hand, this is the worst thing you can do because you have no leverage to control this fish whatsoever. Use the tool that's at your disposal. Use a quality rod, use a quality reel. Once I have the fish come in my way, I'll usually move the rod under my arm and I'll fight the fish more from a horizontal position. If it's a big fish, he's gonna want a dog to the bottom. Control him, but make sure you fight this fish with the center part of the rod and the butt section of the rod. This is where all the strength is. Use the boat to your advantage. As the boat's rocking up and down, you can use that, but do not pump the rod. Worst thing you can do is pump the rod, because remember, you have a 10-ounce weight 8 inches away from this fish's face. If you're pumping the rod, that sinker is moving up and down. The leader line direction is changing on the pull of the fish, and that may just cause that hook to fall right out of that fish's mouth and break your heart. When you do start to feel this fish coming up towards the top and you know he's getting closer, just stay calm. When you start to see your top shot knot come up, just bow your tip down a little bit. Help the knot through the tip top. When you come in and you start to see color, again, go slow. You get the fish near the top. Do not let the fish break the surface of the water. Let them stay there for just a second. By that time, the mate should be right next to you. If the mate's right next to me over here, I'm gonna have my rod over here and I'm gonna tell the mate, I'll swim him right over to you. I'll get the fish to where I want it to be. I'll move my rod over to the side so he can net the fish. I move my rod tip up to the sky. I disengage my reel. Enjoy the moment. That's why we blackfish.